Hello everyone. Welcome to this Bold Reports tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to add the Report Viewer control to your React application. Let's dive in and elevate your reporting experience. If you want to enhance your React application with advanced reporting features, the Bold Reports Report Viewer control is a great choice. It provides interactive report viewing, customizable views, and real-time data access. Its seamless integration and cross-platform compatibility make reports accessible on any device. The control supports parameter-driven reports, connects to any data source, ensures secure access to sensitive information, and offers user-friendly APIs. Additionally, you can export reports in PDF, Excel, Word, and CSV formats. Before creating a React application, ensure your development environment is set up with the following. I have already installed Node.js on my machine. Now, I need to install the Create React App package globally. This package provides a simple way to create a single-page React application with a ready-to-use build setup and no configuration required. So, I run this command to install it. Next, I will create a new React application by running this command and naming the app React Report Viewer. Once the application is created, I need to install the necessary React class and packages. First, I change the directory to the application's root folder. And then run this command to install the type definitions for Create React class. Next, I install the Bold Reports React package by running this command. After that, I open the application folder in Visual Studio Code. Bold Reports requires the window.jQuery object to render the React components. So, I create a globals.js file in the src folder and import jQuery to it. Similarly, I import the React library for building user interfaces, the Create React class library for defining components with a legacy API, and the React DOM library for rendering those components in the DOM. By assigning these imports to global variables, I am ensuring that they are accessible throughout the application or in the browser console without needing to be imported repeatedly. Then, I open the index.js file and import the globals.js file to it. Next, I need to import the Bold Report Viewer scripts and styles. To do this, I open the app.js file and add them. I remove the existing code within the app function and create a div element to serve as the container for the Bold Report Viewer on the web page. The style attribute is used to apply inline styles to the div, defining its height and width. Inside this div, I add the Bold Report Viewer component tag to render the report viewer. In this tag, I include the ID attribute and assign the value report viewer container, which specifies a unique identifier for the HTML element. Next, I will initialize the web API service in the application. I create the report service URL and report path API parameters with their respective values. The ID attribute specifies a unique name for the HTML element. The report service URL, set to localhost, indicates that the service is running locally on the same machine as the application. The API/report viewer path is the API endpoint for the report viewer service. I have included a link to a video about using the ASP.NET Core Web API reporting service in this video's description. Finally, add this line at the top of the file. If you encounter the Bold Report Viewer component is not defined error when running the application, this will resolve it. Now, everything is ready to run the application. I will execute this command, and the report will begin loading in the browser. As you can see, the Sales Order Details report is rendered. In this video, I have shown you how to add the Report Viewer control to a React application. If you found this video useful, Click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.